The secret to recording good quality audio is to have the microphone as close to the person speaking as possible. Now, for most people, the easiest way to do this would be to use a wireless mic set. There are many different ones on the market, but I mostly use the Rode Wireless Go Kit. They're very small, they have an internal battery, and they work really well straight out of the box. You turn the units on and they connect to one another. The end with the lavalier microphone is attached to the person speaking, and the other end connects to the camera. You attach the lavalier mic onto someone's shirt or tie or jacket, but I always remember to hide the wire as much as possible so it looks neat and tidy. To do this, just feed the wire up through the bottom of their shirt. If someone's wearing a particular item of clothing like a dress or a t-shirt and you can't pin it onto the front, then you could hide it under their clothing. With Rode mics, you would use their latex capsules called Rode InvisiLav. But there are other products on the market that do exactly the same thing. The mic is placed inside the capsule and then that is secured and sandwiched under their clothing with sticky tape. Hollywood tape is very good for this. Once that's done, you don't hear any sound or rustling noises because it won't move at this point. On the whole, I don't mind seeing the microphone, but it can look distracting if it's appearing from the top of their t-shirt or dress. Also, do watch out for lanyards or anything that could rub against the microphone during the interview. If you can, do use headphones to monitor the audio recording, but not every DSLR camera has a headphone output. If your camera doesn't have a headphone jack, then you'll either need to do some tests to make sure you're confident the camera is recording good quality audio, or you might be able to buy an HDMI jack, which you can plug into the side of the camera and then plug your headphones into the jack. This is because HDMI output from your camera is for video and audio. The last part to set up when using wireless mics is to dive into the audio settings. In audio recording, you need to switch from auto to manual. Otherwise, the camera will be adjusting the volume up and down all the time. Also, you'll most likely need to reduce the recording levels to a quarter or even lower to stop the audio peaking and becoming distorted. If there's an audio meter, you want the levels around minus 12, but I'd rather record the volume a little bit lower just to be on the safe side. On the Rode system, there is a low, medium and high sensitivity setting. I normally have mine on medium, but the idea is the wireless mics are doing the hard work, so you can turn down the recording levels inside the camera. If you do this, you should get good, clean audio. If you can, do remember to use headphones every time, as you'll be able to tell straight away if there's a problem during the shoot and not have any nasty surprises when you start editing the footage. When you arrive in the filming location, listen carefully for any distracting noises such as ticking clocks, people in the next door room, door slamming, or loud vehicles going past in the street outside. These are the sorts of things you can't fix in most editing programs. In Premiere, you can certainly get rid of constant noises like air conditioning, but if there's a one-off ding of lift doors opening and closing, or a fire truck whizzing past, you'll struggle to get rid of those sounds. So you just need to be aware throughout the whole filming of an interview and always be prepared to stop and start if there's a distracting sound.